You know, John, I find it pretty amazing. In America today, there is better food and more diets today than ever before. And Americans are the heaviest they've ever been. Okay. In golf, there's more golf instruction, better equipment, and scores haven't gone down over the last like 3 decades. When you move to the investing and trading world, literally, there is more software, internet, the speed of executions. I mean, everything has progressed along just great, but investors and traders are more frustrated today than ever before. I mean, it's just how it is. Why do you think that is the case?
Well, I think a lot of it, Preston, is information overload. People just have too much at their fingertips, really. I mean, how much can you really take in? And then it's incumbent on you to sort through there and figure out what's important. I mean, having all that information, don't get me wrong, it's a great thing. But then having all that information and having to determine what's important and who do you trust and all that kind of stuff. I mean, the trust is a big thing that Wall Street lost. I've heard you talk about it a lot, Preston, in a lot of the conferences that we've done together and in conference calls and the rest. And it's not just us talking about it. I mean, the American public, any investor anywhere in the world, has lost a lot of confidence in the people that gave them counsel on what stocks to buy. I mean, Wall Street pays $1 billion in fines for analysts that are inappropriately recommending stocks that they're in fact laughing about behind the scenes, when they're talking to their buddies. So, that's why the trust was betrayed. And then, like you say, the fact that there's so much information is a lot like all these giant head drivers and things like that. Why haven't the golf scores come down? Well, you still need to, number one, practice. And number two, how do you apply it? How does that translate into you actually playing your best game? And that's why I think you and I have had the success that we've had, both as traders and as educators, is how do you impart that information over to people? How do you tell them this isn't really important? Too many people are following what analysts are saying, and that's really not where you want to be, especially if the analysts are still in these pockets of the big firms that they're recommending.
Yeah, and you've made the comment where, you keep thinking that this is going to change, like the nature of Wall Street is going to change, and that it's going to become friendlier to investors. I guess when I'm saying this, I'm talking about these analysts that you bring up and these big investment firms that seem to just have a control on the news that comes out. And I mean, when they talk about a stock, that stock really moves the direction they want it to. I mean, and so I just find it interesting that over your last 23 years of experience, I mean, have you seen anything change that's going to make this easier for investors, or is there a game being played out there?
There's always games being played. In particular, folks, some of the games that people have played have been just as we've said. They push a stock that they know is a piece of garbage and is not going to perform the way they say it is, but they have an investment banking relationship with that stock. Likewise, there's a lot of stocks out there that have great potentials that are overlooked because they don't have a relationship with a big investment banking house. So it's a real catch-22, finding those stocks that are going to outperform and staying away from some of the stocks, quite frankly, that the big investment houses are pushing. I mean, here's an example. I won't say the name of the investment house, but this particular firm, when McDonald's was having all those troubles back in 2002, late 2002, before they brought in Mr. Cantalupo to run the place, McDonald's was trading around $18 a share. This big bulge bracket firm downgraded the stock at $18 a share. Well, that's the bottom for the stock. They're trying to get you out at the bottom. You want to be getting out at the top, not at the bottom. And listening to that firm, you would have been getting out, like I say, at 18. McDonald's subsequently trades back up all the way towards $29 a share over the next year, and really never saw much lower, certainly not more than 50 cents or a dollar lower than that level at which they were telling people to get out. So when I look at that, Preston, and I see that here's a firm with 16,000 brokers that has umpteen customers that listen to them, and then CNBC and everybody else talking about it.
And repeating it all day long. I mean,
it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy, but the problem is that they have relationships that they're either trying to garner or that they already have with these firms, and many of the calls that they make are very suspect. So, as you say, though, there's all this information out there. How do people dig through it and find, that this is the stock that's going to outperform, or this is the stock that you should be getting out of right now? And those are the two most important things. Which stocks should you avoid, and which stocks should you be getting?